today I'm going to start with the last topic of fourth chapter of PEC, that is duct propagation and troposphere scatter propagation. So first we'll understand about what exactly duct propagation is. So a radio wave propagation technique that allows the transmission of UHF, that is ultra high frequency and very high frequency electromagnetic waves, through the region near the tropospheric layer of the atmosphere is known as duct propagation. Basically, in duct propagation, despite being reflected from the ionosphere or gliding over the surface of the earth, the waves propagate from an end to another by undergoing successive refraction from the troposphere. Duct propagation is sometimes referred to as super refraction. It allows the propagation of the signals beyond the horizon. This means that, unlike surface wave propagation, it permits the signal transmission without assuring the need for having a line of sight distance between the two antennas. Duct propagation is the phenomenon of transmitting UHF and VHF signals to longer distances. The presence of a layer of cool air between warm air generates a duct that guides the high frequency signals inside it like a waveguide. At a height of around 50 meters from the troposphere, a phenomenon exists. The temperature increases with the height. In this region of troposphere, the higher frequency or microwave frequencies tend to reflect back into the Earth's atmosphere instead of shooting into ionosphere to reflect. These waves propagate around the curvature of the Earth even up to a distance of 1000 km. This refraction goes on continuing in this region of troposphere. This can be termed as super refraction or duct propagation. Here, the EVOP image shows the process of duct propagation. The main requirement for the duct formation is the temperature inversion. The increase of temperature with height rather than the decrease in the temperature is known as the phenomenon of temperature inversion. Now we'll talk about the temperature inversion. The main requirement for the duct formation is the temperature inversion. Here the increase of temperature with height rather than the decrease in the temperature is known as the phenomenon of temperature inversion. The temperature of this region generally remains constant here. The region has a dielectric constant which is somehow greater than 1 at the surface of the Earth as it is denser than the region of the upper atmosphere. While on moving upwards as the air density decreases to 0, the dielectric constant attains unity value. So it can be said that dry air has a dielectric constant of more than 1 and the existence of water vapor enhances the dielectric constant further. Thus we can say that dielectric constant is dependent on the weather condition. Now let's just take a minute and try to answer these questions. Duct propagation is due to which layer? Duct propagation occurs at which layer and how long the waves due to duct propagation travel following the Earth's curvature? I hope you got the answer. So duct propagation is due to your temperature inversion layer. Duct propagation occurs at lower atmospheric layers and how long the waves due to duct propagation travel following the Earth curvature, that is 1000 km. Now we'll talk about the tropospheric scatter propagation. The tropospheric scatter propagation is a means of beyond the horizon propagation for UHF signals. Tropospheric scatter propagation uses certain properties of the troposphere, the nearest portion of the atmosphere within about 15 km of the ground. This type of propagation is also known as troposcatter or forward scatter propagation. As shown in this figure, two directional antennas are pointed so that their beams intersect midway between them above the horizon. If one of these is a UHF transmitting antenna and other is a UHF receiving antenna, sufficient radio energy will be directed towards the receiving antenna to make this a useful communication system. The reason for the scattering are not fully understood here, but there are two theories. One suggests reflections from blobs in the atmosphere, similar to the scattering of a searchlight beams by dust particles, and the other postulates reflection from atmospheric layers. Either way, this is a permanent state of affairs, not a sporadic phenomenon. The best frequencies, which are also the most often used, are centered on 900, 2000 and 5000 megahertz. Even here, the actual portion of power scattered to signals incident on the scattered volume is very thin, between 60 and 90 dB or 1 millionth to 1 billionth of the incident power. High transmitting powers are obviously needed here. Lastly, we'll talk about the fading in tropospheric scatter propagation. So tropospheric scatter propagation is subject to two forms of fading. One is fast and second one is slow. The first is fast, occurring several times per minute as at its worst, with maximum signal strength variations in excess of 20 dB. It is often called Rayleigh fading and is caused by multipath propagation. The second form of fading is very much slower and is caused by variations in atmospheric conditions along the path. It has been found in practice that the best results are obtained from tropospheric scatter propagation if antennas are elevated and then directed down towards the horizon. Also, because of the fading problems, diversity systems are invariably employed, with space diversity more common than frequency diversity. Now, let's just take a minute and try to answer these questions. What is the frequency at which tropospheric scatter occurs? What is the range of frequency at which tropospheric scatter occurs? And tropospheric propagation is also known as forward scatter propagation, whether it is true or false. We got the answer. So what is the frequency at which tropospheric scatter occurs? It is above 30 MHz. What is the range of frequency at which tropospheric scatter occurs? That is UHF and microwave range. And tropospheric propagation is also known as forward scatter propagation. This is true. I hope you have understood the concept of duct propagation and tropospheric scatter propagation. Thank you.